guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 9 and 10 of Black Bullet. So let's go ahead and get started with episode 9 in 3, 2, 1, go. No, baby. Did y'all literally walk on her? Jesus. Ooh! Poor baby. Really? Why? Well, something tells me you might be seeing him again by the end of today's episode. Yeah, but Tina, where would you go, though? Yeah, besides, they can fend for themselves. So you just stay with them. Yeah, you would think these two would be very jealous by now. Maybe Montero feels like if he possibly becomes a politician, whatever, that the situations that he's currently facing, he may not be able to pursue them. It's very similar to, like, being a president or a pope or something, and how someone will promise you something, and 50 out of 50, they can never really do those. Why, though? Girl, this is the end of the fucking world. We all dying. So basically, you got 4 days to get the fuck out. Go somewhere. You ain't gotta leave, but you gotta get the hell up out of here. Thirsty. I should have got something to drink before I did this. I'll get it after. Oh, hey, Andrew. I mean, that thing looks like a dinghy compared to everybody else. Are all y'all really gonna be able to fit in that? Oh, Tina. Yeah, you're right. Oh, hell nah. No.
Oh.
Or this just could be a big ass fight. That's showing me? I mean, I was expecting him to be somebody else, but okay. He got a nice voice. All right, see? There you go. Oh! Okay, so, Shoma, and this child must be the most OP of OP in this show. Yes? But she's cute! Like, oh, she's so precious! Like, she was just badass! It's just like, yeah, let me be cute. But are we gonna find out why he left abruptly? Oh, she's so cute. Oh my God. I thought Tina was cute, but Jesus Christ. Babies. Sure. Okay, so you don't know about that. But what if he's lying, though? She's right. You got cat ears? Gonna cry. Oh my God. She cute. Oh. Well, that makes sense, because of course, in the opening. Oh, of course. She'll be fine. Tina. Right. Children. Yes. Oh my God, Mindoto, she'll be fine. Oh. Do we really need a chair? Don't know. I got a bad feeling about this. Because, sometimes my bad feelings are usually right. But, we still got one more episode to figure out to see how this goes. But the fact is that, Rentaro is kept telling Kisahara, like, no, are you sure you're able to do this? Are you in good health? And it's like, damn, like, yeah, I know. We know. But, like, let her not only prove to herself that she knows she can do this, let her prove it to you. Let her show you that she can fucking do this. I'm happy that she's partnered with Tina because, like, bad bitches right there. Because, like, oh my god, I'm so excited! Like, seriously. Also, seeing Shoma, he's a very interesting character, so I'm kind of hoping that, like, with episode 10 and the last few episodes that I have with this show, because I'm guessing the finale for me will be next week, and then I think, I don't know what I'm gonna watch next after this. But I'm hoping that, like, yeah, Shoma gets a lot of, like, ish that, because you have him come onto the show, you talk about him in the first part of the episode, then he pops up. And then when Rentaro asks him about, hey, did y'all kill the people back there? And he's like, what you talking about? Something about that's a little strange to me now. I mean, do we have a traitor among us? I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if we do, 'cause I mean, it happens and such. But I mean, like, even Mirrorin, she's so cute. Oh my god, and I don't want her to be a bad guy because, like, come on, she's precious baby girl, and I already love her so much. She got cat ears, fucking cat ears. Like, oh my god, come on now. Like, we already know. Yes, Tina. It's still best girl because Tina is precious and Tina is just, sleepy baby child, and I love her to death. But you don't need, she's so cute. Oh my god, damn it. Like, come on now. I just, whatever's gonna happen next, I need everything to go smooth. That's all I need. But go ahead and pause the video, and I'll see you guys in 1 second for episode 10. Okay, episode 10 in 3, 2, 1, go. No, you all just tried your best. Mm-hmm. Oh, of course you are. Oh. Oh, you gonna treat him to ice cream? Yeah, so everything's gonna be fine. Oh.
Go lay down, okay? Go lay down.
Oh. Excuse me. Ooh. Okay. Oh, baby. God, that's so sad. Just to know, like, and it's scary too. Like, whoa, God, And of course, there's lowering everywhere now. You okay? Please. Kizahara? Wait! I mean... Yeah, but he already is attached to him anyway. Oh. Mm-mm. They're all dead, aren't they? His babies. Yes, they do. Some poor babies. Oh. I really had to kill some kids today. Oh my god! This damn show. I'm thinking like, oh yeah, there's freaking police over here and caution tape. Like, no, these kids are okay. They're okay. Oh my god. And we barely knew any of them. Only for like a couple of episodes and then nah, we're killing all of them. Oh, God, I can't. Oh, my God, and freaking Andrew, like, oh, she just wanted a show for me. Imagine a girl show. Oh, my God, the equivalent of Pretty Cure. Oh, this hurts. This show, woo, y'all really like to hurt me with some kids. If it's not animals, it's kids! And then sometimes it's both! Oh, God. This might be one of those that when I finish the show, I may not be able to, like, stomach watching this again because this is sad. Like, there's some good moments in this show. Like, do not, like, don't get me wrong. I really, truly love this show. But, like, the tragedy fucking hurts, and when it hurts, it's like it cuts you like a knife, and it goes by so quickly. But like, I mean, with these little girls, like, I barely really got to get attached to them, so like my tears came like very, very late, but still I felt for them, especially with the fact is that all of them wrote like what they wanted to be, and they'll never be able to be that, like. I hate when little kids have to die. Like, it's so sad. It's one of the most, like, tragic things when someone dies. Whether it's a real-life person or it's an anime character. Like, I can't. I hate when it happens. And it's just so, like, my heart. This hit, and it hit hard and strong, and it just got me. Ugh. I can't. It's too much. But other than that, it was a really good episode. Still sad. Really, really sad. I mean, it was very, like, episode 9 was very cutesy and happy and everything. And then 10 was depression. Straight depression with a cute little moments here and there. But some, I don't know why. Like, especially going into how I felt, I was like, something bad's gonna happen. I didn't think it was gonna be that. I really did not think it was going to be that, but Other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episodes 9 and 10 of Black Bullet. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. It really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel. I make videos every single day. Join the Master Squad. And, of course, I will see you guys. I'm guessing the next two episodes are the finale. I'm not 100% sure. But, I think what I'm going to start doing specifically with these Patreon shows, because I didn't say it in Bakuman, but I think I'm going to go ahead and state it, by chance, especially when all of this does come out. I think as of going from forward with all three of these shows, I will have everything come out on Saturday. So I know after I'm done watching my next ish, I need to put that out for Patreons and such. So I will see, Patreons next Saturday. And then for everybody else, I will see you guys on Monday for possibly the final two episodes of this show. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.